Hey guys, and welcome back to another episode of EverQuest 2. And in tonight's episode, I am joined by a really good friend. We have Cypher Deck with us tonight.
Hello everybody, I'm dancing.
And guys, we are going to be continuing the quest over here in Tomorrow's Deep, but one of the things we were looking at in between the videos were these guys over here, and they are just, they're really hideous looking creatures because of this weird protrusion they have in their chest that like actually is hidden by the shield. And then of course, you mentioned they look like they're melted, right?
Yeah, actually I'm looking at really close. I have the camera over top and it looks like their eyes are twitching. Like they don't know if they want to keep them open or closed, and they don't actually have an eyeball.
It's almost like if they've been burned or something, and they've lost control of their muscles. But, you know, I had another theory after looking at their shoes here, and tell me that those do not look like elf shoes.
They look like classic elf shoes.
So I'm thinking maybe these are elves who have escaped from, like, Santa's workshop, and when they left the protective environment of that magical field there, because they're so old, they automatically start getting bigger and they morphed and their body just couldn't handle it because they look stretched out and they look just look at their vest. Their vest actually looks like something you might see on an elf, and the little buckle looks like maybe at one time it was probably small and now it's big. I don't know. It's kind of weird to look at these guys because I don't know any of the backstory on them, and they are huge.
And they have these lines that are like burned into their skin if you look over top, going from their eye all the way down their chest.
Oh, really? So maybe these are the bad elves who try to take presents for themselves, and they gave out too much coal or something during the holidays. I don't know, but very unique looking creatures. I don't think I've ever seen anything that horrifying in a video game before as a creature that is just like a side character. Like, they spent some time on this guy and didn't really ever do anything with him.
Yep. Like, poor guys.
Well, I mean, pretty much any other zone out there at a high level, you can, or any other creatures, I should say, has a zone for them. You know, the Avox, they have Goblin, you know, that has all these zones for them. You got Orcs, every zone out there. This one, I don't think I've ever seen in any zone other than this one.
Yeah.
So, yeah, unfortunately, they got no love. Whatever programmers out there designed that, my sympathy goes to you, man, because I know you probably spent a lot of time and effort to design that creature, and then it just didn't pan out for whatever reason. So, let's see, we need to do what over here? Sir?
I clicked the circle, the buckets that we,
that we poisoned. Tampered.
Yeah.
I'm taking this one.
Alright, I'm gonna just pull a lot of these guys and just let's go ahead and AoE them.
Yeah, because they're pretty low level. So you go that way, I'll meet you around the other side of the tree.
Alright.
And then I'll do my area effects. There we go. One right there.
Where you at?
I'm coming. It's a long run. You're probably gonna kill him before you even get there.
Nope, damage shield is up.
Here we go, area effect coming in. Come on, let me cast it. I got interrupted there.
Yep.
Yes.
Same.
Nice. I didn't even have to do my second one. These guys are so low.
Alright, click the barrels, I guess. Yep.
Now, I kind of feel bad about doing this, but just a little while ago, they were aggro to us. So, giving them barrels that I know are poisoned and contaminated because I did that, you know, it's not like I can say no. It's not like I can tell them and warn them that maybe they shouldn't be drinking this or eating the syrup.
It's gonna be all right.
I guess, you know, if it was really a RPG game in the sense of like hardcore D&D style game, you would have to have done this in the right order. Otherwise, you would kill those people off and get bad faction with them by turning this in.
You never know; they may actually have resist to the poison, and that's why we're able to do it in this order.
Could be. I mean, that could definitely be something there, but you would have to have known that ahead of time in, like, the old school games for that to, because you wouldn't either want to risk it otherwise, so.
Yep.
Oh, and the name, look at he's up, so I am going to go over there and kill that guy.
Hey, wait a minute now.
Oh, are you killing someone?
I still have two barrels left. there we go. I got him.
I would love to see in future games, and I know they're going to do it because they're always pushing the boundaries, is to see more animations when clicking on stuff like that, whether you're, you know, planting seeds in the ground or, you know, clicking on barrels. Actually show me scooping the honey or the syrup or whatever it is out of the barrel, and maybe even give me a status effect for a little while and saying my fingers are sticky and I'm not able to, you know, do some of the spells that I was able to do before or something along those lines.
Yeah. Are you up at the named or you already killed him?
No, I'm up here. I was going to wait for you to get here.
Okay.
That way you can do the area
effects. I'm bringing friends.
Here we go. Let's go. See how well this is going to work out, guys. I'm doing my area effect.
Oh.
Where's all the guys?
I went up and pulled the name.
Oh, you know what? You ran too far and they reset themselves, probably.
Oh, did they?
Probably, okay. Yeah. It's one of the things you have to worry about in this game, guys, is they try to be nicer to you. Because in EverQuest 1, if you got aggro, you got aggro. That was it. You're going to have that creature on you until you kill them or zoned. 9 strength, 9 agility, and 8 stamina. I think we've gotten a different item off of this guy every single time, haven't we?
Yes.
Well, that just makes me want to kill him more often so we can see his entire loot table.
Yep.
Although he does, just like every creature, have his rare loot tables, the ones that won't spawn very often. And, you know, you may kill him 100 times and never see that one item. It's not as common in this one as it is in EverQuest 1 to have to kill him that many times, but it is a thing that will happen from time to time. So just be, you know, prepared for that creature to not always drop what you want it to drop. But we're not actually killing the creatures for anything in specific. We're just kind of doing it for the fun of it.
Hey.
Two of them. Wow, two chests. Let's see. Templar? Nope, Templar. We don't need that. Advanced Craftsman? No, that's all right.
Yep. I'll get it. I'll take it.
As soon as I start getting some backpacks and stuff along those lines, I will definitely start picking up some more stuff. But my backpacks are so pathetically small right now, guys. Let's see, what do you got in here for us? Something good, some new pieces. Oh, yeah, a new cloak. Let's see what that looks like. Ooh, I like it. It's kind of tattered. That might be interesting to wear.
Okay, I'm sorry about that. you know what it looks like? There's a cloak that you can get from Runny I2 that looks like that. And that's kind of nice that they give you that graphic early on, because that graphic back in the day is signified that you spent a lot of time and went into all the way to the end of the dungeon, and you probably had to do it 2 or 3 times to actually get the cloak.
Right. The only downside to that cloak that I've seen is on a big race, like an ogre or a troll or guardian, barbarian. It's really small. It looks like a bib on your back because you're really tall. So, you know, only small races like this can really shine with it and be like, oh, look how cool this looks on me. You know, other than that, it's kind of cool looking. I like the fact that it's tattered. It looks good for like a necro maybe.
Yep. Where is the,
We gotta kill that Mon Haran now, the name guy.
Do we?
Alright. We don't need those, so I'm gonna decline that. I also need to bring the, we gotta go back and back down, yeah. You wanna do that first?
I don't see a quest though.
Well, no, let's kill the Mon Haran guy, and then we'll go back down there, because it says I need to do what I can to bring back under control. No. Okay, we haven't done that one yet then.
No. It's actually in the very back. We go through the tunnel, and
where they're fighting the war, here,
where the Throoms are, and that's where you get the quest, because you have to go to the rampart where they're defending the fort.
Yeah, they're fighting that big war over there.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see, guys. Area effect incoming. Oh yeah, I take a little bit of damage, but it's not too bad. I like the stun on that one. So I can get the other one off. And then yours kills him. And my pet's still over here attacking. And we did lose one. He went back to his spawn point, so just keep that in mind as well. Let's see. Can we get up here? I think we might have to jump.
I think I got him. I think I can get him. Nope. I know there's a way to get him from down here.
Yeah, you can always cast on him. If you have the cast, there we go. I was able to get up. Takes a little bit of effort.
I got him. I'm pulling them now.
Oh man, just as I get up here.
See?
I do like the color on his wings. That is very vivid blue right there.
Yep.
That's probably my favorite color
I have slain Monhoron.
Oh, another totem. So we'll go ahead and greet on that one. Oh, and yep. You got the activist. Let's see. We'll kill this guy, and then we'll go back up to... Oh, congrats, man.
And there we go.
Anything good?
Let me see.
Let me run over here and grab...
New AoE, or updated AoE, I think. But my Grandmaster is better.
Oh, did you put that one in Grandmaster?
Yeah, my AoE has a Grandmaster. But it's my Grandmaster version is better than the new version that I got.
There we go, we got three guys here. Don't need any of these things, but I forgot to go ahead and kill while you're checking out your new spells.
Yep. All right, let's go ahead and turn in and
let's see, we're gonna climb back up here. So yeah, when you do quest in a certain area, guys, you're gonna have to get familiar with that area because you're gonna be traveling back and forth. They do that on purpose so that if you don't want to get familiar with the area, they're kind of forcing you to get familiar with that area. And I like it because they've spent a lot of time. If you just stop and take a look, come up here to the ledge and look down, you can get a nice view of the entire area that you were just hunting in a little while ago. That's something a lot of people won't do. They won't just take that time to go look. There's nothing here. You don't get anything for taking that look, but you do. You get the beautiful image because somebody sat there and made sure that that wall didn't look good just from down there, but it looked good from up here as well.
Yep.
And I remember plenty of times in old school games where you could only be down there. You never got a big vista, you know, view of what was going on, and you know, I kind of wanted that back then, and I'm kind of glad that they put it in now. So any chance that I get to go ahead,
and the fact that they don't hinder us with invisible walls, which is nice, because that's what would keep you from being able to see this stuff, is the fact that games would put invisible walls to just, it was kind of lazy on their part, saying I don't want to show you.
Right.
I don't want to let you be able to see areas that you shouldn't be in or anything along those lines.
Well, you know, I mean, they did serve a purpose because at the time, space is really always limited. You know, as they came up with 3.5, so they had floppies before, and then they went to 3.5, and then they went to CDs and DVDs and, you know, a whole bunch of, you know, laser disc in between and stuff, so...
Yeah.
As they did that, you know, space became bigger and bigger, and they were able to do more and more stuff with it. Oh, we need some mushrooms now. That's right.
Yep.
So they were always kind of limited by size. And because of that, certain zones or zones in general could only be so big. You also had to remember in EverQuest 1, and, you know, I compare it to that a lot, but they kind of fixed a lot of the issues that they found in that game and incorporated them into EverQuest 2, so you didn't have to go through all of that. In EverQuest 1, they realized, for servers, you could make these huge zones, but the more people that were in that zone, the harder it was on their server, and it was more taxing, and people got more lag, not because of their connection, but because of the actual server side was lagging out. So what they ended up doing was creating a lot more instances so that you would only have, you know, a dozen people in each zone, you know, 20 people, 30 people at max. If you created smaller zones, it took less time for somebody to load into that zone, so the waiting screen was less. And so they try to incorporate that stuff. I think they learned that they went too small. You know, people like the big, sprawling zones. They really feel like it sucks them into the game a whole lot more. Whereas if you have these very, very small zones that are, you know, a couple rooms size and that's it, you just don't really feel like they're worth your time even to load into them, even though they only take like a second. It's just there's nothing in them. Why waste my time? So you do want somewhere in the middle. You want big, but not too big because of your restrictions with computers and, you know, the requirements of hardware. But as those increase, as those become better, the zones, of course, can go back to the original size of just being massive, and you don't have any of the negative sides to go with it. So.
Yeah. Now, in EverQuest Live, they ended up revamping zones, which... I still have issue with because they didn't make them look better. They made them look worse in most parts. So, oh, new arms and all kinds of nice stuff.
Yeah, food and some like books or something to read. So,
yeah. What do we have to get now?
We got to kill, or we have to get eggs.
Oh, yeah.
Even though eggs we poison again. Those? We poison yeah. them. So we're going to give them a whole bunch of poison food and a poison syrup and maybe make them some poison to drink. I don't know. These guys seem like they've had their fill of poison already, so...
And they want to give us items. They want to give us food. I'm not trusting that food.
Right. No, it's food that's made from somebody else because, you know.
Mm-hmm. I believe that.
I'm just going to let you taste it first is all.
Oh, so, okay, I see how it is.
Oh, man.
I'm the patsy. I see how it is. Okay.
Let Mikey try. He'll try anything.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Let's see. Do we actually need the actual eggs, or do we just need any creatures? I think we need the actual eggs.
Actual eggs.
Let's come down here.
Okay, I got one.
Okay, let's see. How far away can I cast it? Oh, I got it. Okay, so I got a poison egg there. There's like 5 eggs over here on this first tree, the home tree. So I'm going to do it there. Because if you're careful... I do wish, though, that the eggs would disappear when you got them.
Yeah.
I mean, I know they're for a separate quest, and if they disappear, they would have to reappear. That would be fine with me. In fact, they are disappearing. That's fantastic right there.
Are they?
Yep, they are on my screen.
Oh, wait.
That's
cool.
It's
a race now. It's a race. we need to get 8. Okay, I'm going to go to the other tree because I see how it is.
That's all right. You can do it on this tree, too.
No, it's all right. It's all right. I'll find my own eggs. Thank you very much.
Well, I mean, I know they're disappearing on my screen, but it doesn't necessarily mean they're disappearing on yours, so.
Yeah, they are.
Oh, are they?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I mean, it should be a little bit like that. It should be very much, you know, a server-wide kind of thing, but I'm torn on that because I do like the ones where if I do a quest where we did those plants and things of that sort, that they were only on my screen because I want the other people who are just coming into the zone to experience that for the first time. But with these, they just respawn anyway, so that's not too bad right there.
Yep.
However, if you're doing this quest and you've already done the other one, the one where people need to poison it, and you see somebody running through these things poisoning them, I would just give them a few minutes and let them do their thing because multiple people can poison the same egg. However, it does seem like once I take the egg, it's gone, and you're gonna have to wait for the repop. So,
yep.
You know, you can be a little bit nice to these people and let them finish their quest off before you kind of steal all the eggs from underneath them. I'm not a big fan of the range though. It seems like you don't have to get too close anymore. It used to be you had to get right up on top of the tree, which means you had to do all this extra fighting. And it made the quest a little bit slower. It also made them a little bit more difficult, which is, you know, right by me. I like difficult. I like a little bit slower. It lets you appreciate the game a little bit more. Let me zoom in so you guys can get a good view of what these guys look like. The orange jumpsuit is just weird.
Yeah.
Now, what would you tell these guys when you sit down and you eat a Chick-fil-A or something? You know, because they're birds, and that might be a little disturbing to them.
I've eaten your family.
It's your cousin.
What do you say to the actual Chick-fil-A whenever you're eating it?
Oh, if it's talking back to me, I ain't eating it. I ain't eating anything that's not already cooked and prepared for me.
Seven. Oh, I see Pops. I just have this one mob. He's my pet now. Just follow me around as I'm getting these eggs.
Did you get all of them already?
I just did, yes.
Okay, I'm going to go back and check on the name to see if he's up. We do have a quest to turn in down below as well, so we'll have to do that. Or maybe not down below, but inside the tunnel there. I think this is the exact same one that we looked at earlier. One of the good reasons to pick them up, even if you don't need them, is, you know, they're going to stay there until somebody does, and they won't respawn in a different spot with a different collectible until somebody picks up those other ones. So if you don't need them, definitely pick them up and sell them. I don't have any space, otherwise I definitely would, but, you know, at least I can let you guys know what the smart decision on that one is. Try not to do what I'm doing, which is just leave them there. And this guy is still not up.
Nope. I can see it from over here.
You're right. He must have like a 20-25 minute spawn rate on that guy. It's ridiculous. Oh, yeah. Yeah, we got some guys. Area effect incoming.
And
there we go.
Boom.
Another area effect. I almost killed him. Got one guy who kind of made it out. Got lucky. Let's see. Also, guys, if you're having lag in this game, if you're not playing on like a state-of-the-art computer and you're just not able to handle it, not having the gorilla following you around is going to help you with that. Anything that it has to render is going to cause a little bit more of a slow effect for you. So just keep that in mind as well.
Yeah.
Oh, sorry, guys. I did get a new cloak, so let's put that on before I completely forget about it. Oh, wow, my backpacks are so full. So ridiculous. Okay, we got that. We need to go back up. What is she, a level 15 guardian? She's been running around a little bit here and there, but mainly I just see her standing there. You know, she'll run to a new spot and then stand there, and we'll run back and forth 4 or 5 times. Oh, no, she's moving. She's moving now, so I wonder if she's playing while she's at work or if she's doing something else while she's playing.
Probably at work. Oh, where'd you go?
Oh, I'm running over the hill. Because that name guy's probably not up yet.
No. Oh, okay.
That's a cool looking weapon that guy has in his hand, too.
Is that the one with the two-hander?
It kind of does look like a two-hander, but it's just a regular, you know, one-handed weapon that he's walking around with. The enemy mob. Are you checking the names?
Oh, no. I didn't. I was going to go ahead and come over here because Mon Haran should be up now.
Do we need him again, or are you just killing him for the loot?
Loots.
Okay. I'll meet you up there from below, and I'll pull everything I possibly can. Ooh, and there's a shiny over here, guys. Nice. I'll have to get it after the fight, though. Let's see. How close can I get without losing the guys from the first spawn? Okay, we got them. If I run back fast enough, maybe? Yeah, we're good. Okay, area effect incoming.
Oh, oh, hey. Did you kill them all?
Nope, not yet. One still left.
Oh, you're over there with the...
Yeah, I got almost all of them right there. Let's see, where's Mon Haran? He's up there. You know what, I think if you...
Accomplished AVIA killer, or hunter.
Oh, nice. I wonder why I didn't get that one. Ship shard, nope, I don't need that one. It's all yours. All right, those shards usually are worth a fair bit of money, though, guys, because they are not easily got. Oh, you already got them.
Oh, yeah, I'm boss.
Yeah, I do love the blue. I wish we could get a plushie of this guy and I could put it in my guild hall. Ooh.
Oh, there we go.
Nice. Finally, a decent piece. Not quite as good as one of my pieces, but better than the other one. So I'll just hit greed on that one.
Yep. Oh.
Congrats, man.
Thanks.
Okay, so let's see.
I think I only had one charm anyway.
Oh, nice. That's going to be... you know, a nice little boon for you, especially with the 9 or was it 8 intel?
Let me find it. Where'd it go?
Doing that, I'm gonna pull as many of these guys.
Ugliest charm I ever saw, and I can't even find it. Oh, there it is.
It's because our backpacks are too small.
Yeah.
We need to get some crates. Crates are amazing. Yeah. I used to run around with them on my warrior or my guardian all the time. They did weigh a lot back in the day. I think they've come down in weight, but for the most part, it doesn't even really matter what class you're playing because you get such great gear in this game that even if you're playing a wizard, you're going to have the strength you need. Why am I running backwards? That is weird.
I told you, remember the glitch the other day? You'll get to a point where you'll turn around.
I can't even go forward anymore. Oh, there we go. Wow, okay, so my guy just, you know, wanted to get a little workout. He wanted to make sure that our friend got here with us, and that's why he was going backwards again. I don't know. That's a little weird. But I'm digging the cape. I do like the way that looks.
Yeah. I wonder if it's because you clicked on something that was behind you?
No, I mean, I had killed everything. I didn't have anything clicked as far as, flower shrubbery maybe me? I don't know. I think that's weird, though. Oh, man. I do wish there was more cave zones, because it does have a nice, you know, closed-in feel to it.
Yeah. Now, there is one when we get up into the 90s, that, or, well, it's 80s, that I really do like.
As a cave?
Yeah, it's a cave, and at the end of it, it has, I think, two or three names depending on which way you go. All right, so we just got arms?
Yeah, and it has 9 intelligence on it, but I lose 8 stamina. I only gain 1 intel out of it. Yeah. But it does have more mitigation, so I'm going to go with it regardless.
Yep.
You know, one benefit, though, guys, is if you play the warriors or the melee guys, you will find that as you get new pieces of armor, you actually get to see what every piece looks like versus the casters. You're only getting to see what the robes look like, so that's kind of a little unfortunate. Oh, crap. That is why I was doing it, because I had my attack on, apparently, and I don't know how to turn that off. What am I doing? Let's go back. Actually, I didn't get any bad faction for that one.
Okay, so we want to follow over here.
Oh, you don't want to kill these?
We can, but we're going to need them in a second.
Okay, let's skirt by them then.
Yeah, we're going to... Looks like that guy with that mercenary is coming through to kill these guys anyway.
Oh, I got one.
Oh, I got one, I think. Maybe? Or unless he got it.
And there's the book right over there, guys. Not too far away. The thing I like about this area is something I was talking about earlier, where it shows up on the map as you do things. If you look at the way it looks right now, there's some little siege engines over here, not too many. These are freaking huge for my class right now. But yeah, there's a few of them here. As we do this quest, we're going to get more and more of them to kind of show up, and you're going to actually see them fire off. In fact, I think you can see these things fire off over here right now. Nope, they're not firing at the moment.
We have to get the parts for it, I think. Oh, okay. Which is in those tents that you were just showing.
So we got a gem out of that one. What else you want us to do, guy? Ooh, symbols of intelligence. Oh, yeah. That's going to be nice. Okay, and then we got another one over here on the other side as well.
Greetings.
Yep.
What do you want us to do? You want us to check the steamers southwest. Yep. Okay. We can definitely do that. This is right over here into the corner.
Oh, there's two of them, actually. There's this one and the one when we came right into the zone. Or right into this area.
Right. Okay, a steamer had an undamaged terminal gauge.
Oh, this is... Oh, okay. Never mind. I'm thinking of a different one. Or is there the other one?
There must be another one. Yeah, he said check another one. So.
Okay.
Let's go back down this way. And again...
And I think there's one in a tower as well.
Hmm. Oh, is there... We need to kill this sky screecher anyways, so... Let's
snag
this guy.
Yeah, let's go ahead and pull. Oh, you got another one than I did.
Oh, I didn't even see that one. Let me come over to you. Ring around the rosy, man. Ring around the rosy. There we go. I got him killed before he even got over here. Actually, I should say my pet did. I do love how there's corpses on the ground. Like, there's a big battle been going on, and both sides have lost people. I do believe that most of the time when you see things like that, they will give you a quest to go and revive people or pick loot up off of the enemies or your guys, you know, weapons, that they can then recycle, and it makes sense, you know, it makes sense that they are doing quests like that in that area.
Yep.
Okay, we got...
The other one's over here.
Yeah, I think she's doing the exact same one. We might go ahead and try to invite her into the group and see if she wants to join us. Let's see, invite into group. That way, if, you know, she's killing the same creatures, might as well get the experience for it and let her get the updates for it as well, so...
Yeah.
Oh, and she declined it. Okay, so she doesn't, she wants to go solo. Okay, I got two guys over here. I'm going to do area effects on them. Where are you at?
Okay. I got one more.
Oh, you got one on you?
Yep.
Yeah, she may not be on for very long, which might be why she doesn't want a group, or maybe she just wants to play by herself. No harm in that, but I would suggest, guys, if you're playing an MMO, to go ahead and take the extra effort and, you know, be part of a group, because otherwise you might as well just play a single player game.
Yeah.
And then you don't have to worry about competing.
There's always been that ideal that people want to play EverQuest or an MMO without it being the MMO where you can only play it as a solo server.
Like a Skyrim kind of thing?
I guess, but that defeats the purpose. of well, it being an MMO, but
yeah, for it being an MMO, but for the sheer wide scale content that's available in an MMO, I understand people wanting that in a single player, and they definitely do because Skyrim is that, Fallout is that kind of game. It's huge. It has a lot of stuff in it, and it's a single player game. So
yeah,
there's a demand
oh,
for.
Oh, here
it.
We go. Here we go.
Yeah, three guys in one. Okay, let's see. Area effect. There we go. One more. Come on, earthquake. Nice.
Cool. And one more.
Nope, don't need that. We need one more?
Yep, I do at least.
Yeah, same here. I think we can find it on the way back up, maybe, or maybe not. Yeah, maybe not. Oh, there's one up there in the tower. Ooh, it's okay. A captain.
Let's kill it.
Let's see if I can bring him down.
Names, y'all. Names.
I don't know if he's a named. He does have a named. But I don't know if he's going to drop loot every single time. He doesn't have a star next to his name, and we've never killed this guy, so...
Yeah.
Yep, there we go. Just a regular dude.
Ah.
Probably for a quest. Probably for one of the later ones. We'll get it in a second. Have to wait like 20 minutes for him to respawn.
Yeah.
But guys, as soon as we turn these things in, I'm thinking we're going to go ahead and end the episode. I do want to thank you all for coming out and watching. If you do enjoy these videos, be sure, hit that like button, subscribe. But more than that, go check out my Twitter feed. I am going to be doing some Comic-Cons or some gaming conventions this year. And that's where I'm going to be doing the updates. I'll be sending pictures and videos and things of that sort on that that little feed right there. So if you want to see that as I do it, definitely go hit that up. Very, very interesting to check those things out. This would be the first time I've ever gone to, you know, the big ones. I've gone to some of the smaller ones like Gearbox's Community Day, and it was very cool to meet Adam Sessler and Morgan Webb there. But I'm hoping to check out some of the new ones here in Houston, because they have a lot of gaming conventions in the area, Galveston, Austin, you know, all that stuff. So definitely hit those things up. If you're watching on my channel, check out Cypher Deck. He does a lot of really cool Let's Plays. EverQuest 2 is just one of the ones that he does. Grow Home is one of the ones that he does. Or was it Grow Up or Grow?
It's Grow Home. Home. Yeah, yeah. Grow Home.
And then there's you do EverQuest 1. You also do a whole bunch of other ones. If you want to give them a couple list of some of the newer games that you're going to be adding pretty soon.
Kingdom of Avalar is another one. Skyrim. And I'm always looking for new games to play, so... always going to have something out there for you guys to watch, so definitely check it out.
And again, guys, thanks for watching. Until next time.
Like